So welcome to our Stanford Geriatric Education Center course online for ethnicity and dementia care. In this first introductory module, there are two very large trends that are occurring in the U.S. society right now that make this course extremely important. And one is what we call the ethno-geriatric imperative, and the other is our looming epidemic of dementia. So the confluence of those two trends is what we're going to be concentrating on in this module. In terms of the ethno-geriatric imperative, we hear a lot about the geriatric imperative, that is, the growth of the older population, the aging of the baby boomers, and so forth. What we don't hear as much about is how within that population, the growth of the diverse populations that make it up. Probably more importantly, we need to recognize that we have increasing numbers and proportions of elders from different ethnic populations, but the diversity within those populations is increasing dramatically. So there is what we call the ethno-geriatric imperative facing us, to the extent that the projections are that by mid-century, 40% of older adults in the United States will be from one of the ethnic minority populations. So this is what it looks like visually. We can see that the Latino population is growing most rapidly and will be one of the major population groups in the future, along with the African-American and Asian and to some extent other populations. So these are what we call the minority populations. And more explicitly, the African-American population is projected to grow of older adults. These are people 65 and older, are expected to grow from 8% to 11% of all the people 65 and older in the United States. The Asian Pacific Islanders are expected to grow from 2.3% to 9% by mid-century. The Latino elders are expected to grow from 5% to 20%. And the American Indian population is actually also growing more rapidly than the non-minority population, and it will be growing from 0.4% to around 1% of the total population. I should also add that in 2010, 1% of all older adults identified themselves as being from two or more races. But one of the first lessons that we have to learn is that the term minority completely underrepresents the diversity of cultures that geriatric providers are going to be facing. Just to give you some examples of that, in the Asian Pacific Islander population, the over 30 national origins are included. And within those individual national origins is a great diversity of education, religion, language, and so forth. So they come from around half of the globe, actually, and speak many different languages. And the Hispanic Latino population of older adults includes not only people from Spain, but also from any other country whose national origin is Spanish, which includes all of Latin America, the Caribbean, and so forth. American Indian Alaska Natives, they're are over 500 nationally recognized tribes and villages and rancherias, but many others that are not recognized officially. Each of those tribes has its own language and culture and history, so that even though as a whole the American Indian population of elders is relatively small comparatively, it is extremely diverse. In terms of African Americans, we see that there is a lot of diversity in terms of socioeconomic background, education, religion, geography, and also increasing numbers of people who consider themselves, by census data, Black or sometimes African American, but they come, they're immigrating from parts of sub-Saharan Africa. So that includes places like Somalia, Sudan, and so forth. There are also Black populations in the Caribbean. So all in all, we have the diversity that geriatric providers will be faced with is growing rapidly, and there's a necessary set of skills that are going to be important for geriatric providers to have in order to work effectively with these populations, especially in the area of dementia care.